communication and journalism from Kenya Methodist. I grew up in a very, I would say, middle class family. I went to State House Primary, and then after that I went to Mary Hill. It was a national school. It's still a national school. I performed well. I started school at State House Primary, and then after that I went to Mary Hill Girls. After graduating high school, I went to study abroad. I went to the U.S., University of Central Missouri. And then I came back home because I couldn't finish my studies, so I came back home. I went to Kenya Methodist, where I graduated with a bachelor's degree in communication and journalism. After that, I started out at People Daily. After People Daily, I worked for a year, maybe 2 years. And then I went to Standard Group. At Standard Group, I did well, as I was then recruited to Nation Media Works for 5 years. So after that experience, in 2020, I was then awarded the Presidential Award. I was given the Presidential Commendation. I also, at that particular time, won the Times Reuters Foundation Award. I did exemplary well throughout my career. I was able to travel to a few places. I went to London. I went to a few countries here and there, Uganda, Tanzania, Burundi. So in 2020, after I got the state commendation, I was diagnosed with depression. So having been diagnosed with depression, I was admitted at Bustani in 2020. And then I was put on medication for depression, anti-anxiety, antidepressants. Then I coped with the medication. After a year, again, I was admitted. And then the third time after being admitted, with depression, people don't know. People say you're depressed. What does that mean? So it took a bit of struggle with work and everything. People used to think, ni kujiekelea tu. So having been depressed, I turned to alcohol, and alcohol and medication do not work. So I used alcohol as a tool now instead of focusing on the medication. So I used that as a crutch, and then I resigned because work was heavy. I couldn't just cope. I resigned in 2021, I think, yeah. Then from then on, I started doing freelance work here and there. Then last year in October, the drinking was very heavy. And then that's how I ended up here with the person. I don't know if you've seen him. He was here a while ago. Yeah, so we were together for a while. Yeah, that's my story, my journey. That's how I ended up here. The streets. I used to live in Kilimani. Then I moved to Kawangware when I was not working. I was not getting a stable salary. My family has been really supportive, not to lie. It's just that I want to be independent. So that's how I chose, rather than be home and then you're told what to do as a grown-up. So I decided, let me just focus on myself and do it from scratch. If I did it once, I can do it again. So now I'm looking for a second chance to do it all over again. Maybe this time it will stick. Yeah.
Why streets though? Why streets?
No, I don't have the money to pay rent and stay in my own house. Actually, that's what I'm looking for. Mm-hmm. I'm looking for a house, which I think should be possible soon enough. Yeah, but I want to do it on my own. My family can help. They can really help. I want to do it on my own. Yeah.
So you don't need any help?
No, not that I don't need any help. I just want to do it on my own. I'm very independent minded. That's how I was raised, to be very independent. Asking for help is very hard for me. Yeah. Wow. Unaishi mahali, there's no steam, there's no electricity, there's no power. And then, of course, you've seen where I stay. The area is ridden with water, so you expect mosquitoes. you know, it's I don't think it's not easy, but you cope with what you have. Yeah. No, you just learn to deal with it as the days go by. So as days go by, you just learn, and then you say, tomorrow is another day, so we'll see what happens.
Yeah. How do you feel living here?
It has its challenges, but it's not where I belong, to be honest.
Yeah. Okay, from your experience of depression, what can you tell someone who is depressed outside there?
Seek help. Talk to someone, anyone. It doesn't have to be family. Just talk to someone who's willing to listen and not judge you. Actually, a stranger is better because they won't judge you. When you're talking to someone who knows you, they already know, hey, you grew up well, what is depressing you? But if you talk to someone you don't know, yeah, you can vent, you can say this and this and this, and they won't judge you, and they'll understand. Even if you say, oh, my brother alifanya hivi na hivi tukigrow up, they won't feel, oh, sasa, they go back and tell the brother or someone. Yeah, so just seek help, talk to someone, anyone.
Umesema hapa hapa lazima? Hapa lazima ulale wa?
Lazima ulale na kisu ama rungu.
Uko na rungu hapa?
Mtu anaweza kutokezea tu siku ya tuwa rungu.
Okay. So kai na hapa ndio ni avoid your light. So kisu ni ya protection, eh?
Ai, hapa unaweza shukia tu siku wa tuwa. Kwa somo ya hiyo.
Okay, so ibuni ambia story yako, mama. What happened? Why are you here? What
I was in 2020, mm-hmm. I had nini, I was given the presidential award nini, but ni vile walichuja tuko ofisi, so I was among the five that were left in the office.
As the presidential office?
No. Nation. So vile tuliachwa hiyo kazi ikanisumbua, yani unaona watu wakikufa hiyo time ya COVID. So ndo nikabaki kwa ofisi, and then I was diagnosed with depression.
So what are you specialized in? What do you
like? Health.
Health. Can you just explain?
Oh, I was a health reporter.
Yeah, health reporter.
Based on my history, babangu pia ni clinical officer. So that was my knowledge. Nili understand vile babangu anafanya kazi, hata mimi nikajifundisha hapo. Yes. So I was a health reporter. Ile time ya COVID hata nani alikuwa ananitanga mtahi.
Mtakagwe.
Nasibo. Yeah, that's what I specialized in, and then after the diagnosis kuna siku tu nilikaa hivi kwa ofisi nikasema, "Eh, mimi nataka tu kukupa." Ndio nikaadmitiwa Chiromolin Hospital. Ndio nikaanza kupatiwa antidepressants. Yes, until nikaenda mara ya kwanza, nikaenda mara ya pili, mara ya tatu ndio nikasema
So you were working as a health officer, as a
health writer.
And what really led you here? Like, why did you decide to come here? Tell me about your education history.
My education history. I went to State House Primary.
You went to State House Primary.
And then after that, I went to Maryhill. Ile time in Maryhill, ilikuwa Maryhill. Right now, do you know how many national schools? At that time, it was only 16 national schools. I performed well, I went to Maryhill, and then I was called to Keele University in the UK. Babangu akasema, ni expensive. So when I got a scholarship ya kumsaidia kidogo, not full scholarship.
Ya kukusaidia ama kusaidia baba?
No, partial scholarship. Ndiyo akakubali, nikaenda University of Central Missouri. Nikasema broadcast and communication and broadcast journalism.
So you came back with all this knowledge after 4 years, 5 years?
No, I went there for 3 years. I came back, nikakam nikaanza internship at MediaMax. So vinye lilianza tu internship after 2 weeks, they were like, who's your intern? Nikapatiwa job. Hapo ndo nikaanza kazi MediaMax, then I went to Standard, then I went to, I've never in my life applied for a job. Nile tu mtu anaona tu kazi yangu ananiita.
Well done. Go.
Yes, well, I'm saying I've never applied for a job in my life.
So you've been lucky. Internships and then you get a job.
Yes. At a national level. Kuja kesho asubuhi, me, I think I'm going for an interview. Nimejiprepare. Nimekuja na makaratasi. Naambua, hey. Naambua ndio desk yako.
So, how was the experience, Nation? Why, what, nini exactly lichangia wewe kutoka Nation?
Nation ilikuwa ni depression. For real. At standard, nilitoka standard nilikuwa na mimba. Na sikuwa naweza, walikuwa nanipa pesa kidogo ndio nikatoka. So when nilitoka Nation, I was more than happy and I was paid more than everyone. I was being paid 100,000 plus.
So in 2021, then in 2020, then you got a COVID. Hii job ya COVID as a health
At that time unajua hiyo time ya COVID everyone was dying. Hiyo time mtoto wangu alikuwa ananikimbilia namwambia lazima sijui nifanye nini, ni sanitize kabla nishike, na yeye understand. She was like, what, 3 years at that time? So mtoto wa 3 years unajaribu kumexplain kuna disease inaitwa COVID. Ni kujispray kwanza ndio mhug. Yeah, ataki anataka kuhagiwa kwanza. So I think in 20 when sasa yako na baba yake.
I was almost asking where is he now.
Ana yako na baba yake.
How is the feeling kukaa bila yeye?
Because baba yake, nikimpata baba yake hakuwa active. In fact baba yake alimjua tuko barabara. There was Lilingangana mpaka tukaishi Kilimani. So venye alikuwa ameenda ku cover story. He's a very famous person, I don't want to mention.
He's a journalist.
Yes. Very famous. Sasa venye alitokelezea hivi kwa barabara, mtoto amemgandia, anashangaa. Ai. Yeye anamjua, ameona pictures, but anashangaa ni aje huyu mtoto amenigandia. Hapo ndo waka build relationship. So sasa hii ako na yeye.
Na mbona hakukusupport time uingie kwa media wewe? Because now you are think like you could feel that things were going the wrong way, and you already depression ishaanza kuingia. And as a man, I think kuna ile feeling tunakuanga nayo, yeah.
According to his understanding, naona ni kama ni kitu ya yani depression bado watu wangu wangili. Yeah, naona ni kama ni check ile some type of disease.
What do you think the child is doing now?
She's very fine. Most of my things.
Oh, it's a she.
Yeah, she goes to Makini school, she's in grade 2, she's fine.
You see?
But ile mapenzi ya mama haiko, that is what hurts me. I'm sure kuna mali anakaanga hivyo anasema kwa mama yangu. She's very fine. She eats well, she sleeps well, she goes to school well. But hiyo yote bila mapenzi ya mama, I think inamuuma. Na pia mimi ningekuwa the same thing if I don't have my mother with me. Afadhali nikae na mamangu nikule kidheri kuliko eat pizza, eat whatever.
What hurts you the most in life?
The fact that siko na mtoto wangu, that hurts me.
That's the only thing that hurts you the most.
That hurts me the most.
How is life kwa street? What's the most challenging thing? What's the difference between siku yenye ulikuja na now that umezoeana na street?
Now, the fact is, ono yu masha venye na kana ye. Anaweza ni treat venye nataka juu nafikiria I have nothing. That was hard.
Yeye ndio mzee wako
sasa. At least ningekuwa na option, naweza toka na niende kana nimeendaga, but naona kani yana ni providea kila kitu. So na ni treat venye nataka. That's not fine.
What do you miss the most?
Independent.
Being independent.
Yeah, you can just decide unaamka unaenda hivi unaenda hivi. You decide to go to Karen Mall, you decide that that lack of independence because you don't have financial stability. So mtu anakutreat venye nataka and so be. Na pia wewe huwezi jitreat venye ungetaka. You have to rely on someone.
How much do you get around the streets?
Kazi nakonga Monday na Friday.
Ni kazi gani?
Monday na kazi, sorry. Kazi ya kwenda kuchimba.
Kuchimba mtu, hiyo kuni kutaka maplago, machuma.
Ndiyo kuja tena upili.
So from journalism to doing street recycling.
But again, from that nini nimelearn vitu mingi. Unaweza toa takataka yako na unajua how unaishi.
Unaweza toa?
Unaweza toa takataka yako nipatie. I will know how you live. nakulanga ugali, nakulanga githeri.
Oso nikukupea takataka yangu ya nyumba.
I can tell how you.
Unajua vizuri venye naishi.
Najua venye unaishi. Unaweza niringia hapa lakini ndajua venye unaishi.
So unaweza kuja kuchukua takataka kwangu. But then deep inside wewe kama mwenye amekuja ku inaitwaje umehitaji
kuchimba.
Wewe kama mwenye amekuja kuchimba tayari you know.
I know.
How my life is.
Kwa nyumba.
You know this guy is sick.
Kujifanya.
Umseni mgonjwa. Yes.
Kama kuna mali tunaendanga. Tunatoa adult diapers, unajua kwa kuna mlimavu. Yani, there are very different things you can tell from just that.
How are you health-wise?
I'm fine. I'm a bit, nime lose weight. You know, kumuka vini kwa nime lose. Yeah. Other than that, I'm fine. I thank God. Shashikuwa na pneumonia. Mbanga tukuta tuwile, nilijifungi.
The environment, you can't tell me that you're shikwa na pneumonia.
I'm just shikwa na pneumonia.
How long have you been here?
What happened? Ninukiwa mgonjwa itapidi uende.
Osi.
Ile osi. Kuna osi tumelanga. I had to lie. Nitwa swap.
Nitwa?
Swap.
Swap. Osi inajita swap.
Iyo ni ya. Ulazima wende udanganye ndio provide health ya nini street workers.
Oh, lazima udanganye ndio provide health ya street workers. Okay.
So unaenda unasema hey, mimi malaya. Oh, nadinga mara. Yani you have to lie.
Oh, unasema wewe ni malaya, mnakulana mara ngapi nini? So hata kama mjakulana lazima tuseme mmekulana.
So kama tunaenda na mashamba shaka ngapi ni kile. Ndio upatiwe hiyo kadi sasa uko unapata ni free kila kitu dawa nini na hiyo uta access hapa kwa level 4 hii government nini hospital uta access hapo ni easier kupata hapo kila kitu
haiko hapa Kibera
iko hapa Kibera
Olympic yani
hapa karibu na Equity hapa tu kitu
Okay, ungepewa chance kwa hii life a second slight chance hawa ni wa Kenya. If someone would give you a second slight chance, because unakaa mrembo, I can already see through the smile. If opportunity, what would you do with it? Which one would you want?
I wouldn't want to, but the one thing.